Mentor Guy once again back on another edition of Talk That Shit, where we talk that shit about that shit. If you ain't shit, you ain't got shit to worry about, alright? On my left, Gangsta Salute, just state your name, man.
Got him like OJ, man. Southside. You know, shout out to Melly Mayhem, Three Kings and all that. Shout out to Southside Unk, you feel me?
Salute Unk for the camera world. All that. On my right, Gangsta. Yo, General.
Man, call me what you want. That's my new name. Call me what the fuck you want.
What?
Big Swift.
Huh?
Your daddy in the way. I might be some of you niggas' daddy. That's my name.
Oh, shit.
Yo, shout out
some
to Three Kings.
Some of your moms was starting out.
Shout out to Three Kings.
They was running the wagon on it.
Southside Hulk in the building. Shout out to On Site. Blackhearted. Yeah. Team Hiddle 50-50. Shout out to the First Lady of On Site.
On our far right, introduce yourself, even though you don't need an introduction.
I'm Tan, a.k.a. Sugar Can, Tan K, a.k.a. Tan Dinner, a.k.a. I don't play.
Talk that shit.
That's that at all.
So we're going to talk with the homie M-Way real quick. Like, please explain your name, bro. Like, I smoke a lot, so I think a lot. So that fucked me up. Where it come from?
M-Way stand for McCree Way. That's what the M-Way stand for, you feel me? Or we all started out there. It was Bronson at first, you feel me?
Right, well, Special West Side shit.
I'm gonna tell you about that, you feel me? Bronson, and, you feel me? But back in the day, we was Bronson and shit. But now, you feel me, like, change the street name and shit for me, word. So, McCree Way, but honestly, my name OJ, so everybody call me M-Way. I'm just running with the M-Way because everybody called me it, but it's really my hood, you know, where I'm from. It's a lot of other M-Ways, so, you know, M-Way Dev, M-Way, all that, so.
I like OJ, because you been killing bitches.
So another question is, how long you been battle rapping, you know what I mean?
Man, I've been about 3 years now, man.
And I hear you've been putting in work, though. Yeah, I hear you've been putting in a lot of work. So, I'm saying, any bodies lately? Any casket? Do we need to take, you know what I'm saying, a moment of silence for somebody?
Somebody needs to take, like...
Hold on, before we take a moment of silence for anybody else, we got to take a moment of silence for King Fame, man. God rest his soul, man. His mama dressed him nice that day. All right, now back to it. So, again, back to this casket you was talking about.
That nigga died.
Now, new casket.
New casket.
Memory's making a lot of money off of
that. Word. I'm hearing.
Rochester General was giving bets out, man. I told niggas we could bet that cash, all that shit, man.
That spread?
Like, all that. Word. I came in there and caught a body on my birthday.
Hold on. I like that. You caught a body on your birthday, without a doubt. It was a 30. Mm-hmm. But I'm mad at you because you dug that body back up.
Hold on, what you mean?
Yeah.
The footage ain't dropped.
Mm-hmm.
You come
that's
up,
a fact.
Time, what's
that's
up
fact.
Out there?
That's a
drop the
what's
footage.
Up, come on now.
But him and that last body he's speaking on, they battled previously and the footage never really dropped. It didn't get out there like that.
Yeah.
So for us that know it happened before to see it again, and then it happened like that, it was awful.
I want the footage to drop, though.
Yeah.
So, yo, Time, we definitely need, you know what I'm saying, to see that.
You gonna make me call him like that.
Yeah, he told me, though, that footage got lost somehow or something like that,
man.
But it's mad footage like that.
All right, so go to the tweaking the system. Yo, that
was
coming up next.
We can't be losing.
I was told it was, he had lost. The cameraman lost like the audio part of it.
Oh,
it was something messed up with the audio. So he had the footage, but just not all of the audio part.
Shenanigans. Are you calling bullshit?
I'm calling bullshit.
Are you calling bullshit?
Because last time that same person battled.
Hold on. Before anything. Free my nigga
Leeway. On that note,
we're going to say, you know what I'm saying, salute to you, General, you know what I mean, Free Leeway, and we'll be right back. We'll be right back. What you got coming up though?
Shit, man. Nothing much, man. Feel me?
Any music out?
Halloween coming up, shit. I'm about to take my kids trick or treating and shit like that.
I'm
about to battle this nigga be gone too though, but that shit.
The battle of the South Side. Yeah. King of the South Side.
What's up with all this?
I've been hearing a lot of, you know what I'm saying, son putting up videos.
Yeah.
He going to ask stores if they got OJ and all of that.
I'm asking, even with y'all, like, that's not a good tactic. I'm looking at him like, bro, why you?
Who are you thirsty?
Some niggas say when niggas say that pause shit, niggas be gay minded. It's the fade right now.
It's a battle rap type term now for me.
It's
like
the fade. It's just like my gun so big.
Or some niggas over you. Some niggas feel me reach out.
How many times they use my gun so big?
I mean, in general, not just in battle. I mean, in general, you can say anything you hear in pause. Like, come on, son.
It's kind of fugazi with these new niggas, man.
Don't get me wrong, though. It's a couple of fads I've heard, and I'm like, whoa.
Where does all of this stem from? Because if y'all both from the South Side, you know what I mean? Repping different hoods, but it's all the same thing. Yeah. You know what I mean? South Side, salute to the South Side, all these people on the South Side. What's the problem? Somebody let me know.
At the end of the day, like, the nigga be going was just battle rapping, and niggas was watching him and shit, and I'm like, all right, from me putting on his first battle, he battled some nigga named Crack. But, like, niggas ain't even watch that shit, from me. So it's like, all right, he won. But niggas ain't watching shit, so it's like, all right, bro, you put on because you won. Then he battled Breezy Nights. Nigga smoked his boots, so I'm like, damn, bro, you got your boots smoked.
I was there for that.
That's how niggas got Buffalo, right?
Yeah, nigga, I was
there for that.
So I'm like, you got your boots smoked, bro, you got to get on your shit.
Then
after that, like, I don't know exactly who I think was Traffic, the nigga from Chicago, came up here, smoked his boots, you feel me? So then they like, yo, the niggas in the hood, like, yo, I'm not going to be doing battles and shit, man. He keep getting smoked.
No.
And all that
traffic
shit.
Didn't make it.
No, Traffic came up here. I was at the Traffic battle. That's when I battled.
Wait a minute, you talking about Life in the Gutter?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Sure, I'm talking back in the day before my boys are still in
right,
the
right, hood. Right, yeah. Right. Right.
Like, you're
right.
This nigga was getting his ass whooped, and niggas in the hood, like that actually know him and know me, was like, I'm like, yo, y'all coming up to the battle? Like, be going get his ass. I ain't going up there. I'm not choking on some shit.
I'm not even going to hug people.
That's what I'm saying.
If you're going to sit down, let's talk about this.
And that's what niggas are saying. That's what niggas are saying, basically. You feel me? So I'm like, all right. Cool, friend, and dandy, or whatever. Feel me? Like, I don't know B going for. It's like, I don't chill with him in a hood type shit. You feel me? Like, I'm from the Tway. He from VA. Feel me? I got some VA goons and all that, but I don't.
So I don't know who he is, like, how you gonna do it?
I said the nigga might win the coin toss.
Ace?
The nigga. That was the first body when I battled. He might win the coin toss. That's what I'm saying. That's when Swift battled East Key that same night. Feel me? When I battled nigga Ace.
Yeah.
Feel me? But I told him, like, he might win a coin toss. I won the coin toss. That was a 4-0. You crazy?
Yeah.
Word. So now it's like, I battled Leeway. They like, oh, so what y'all call this? I'm like, man, y'all asked me the same shit last time.
Right.
It's going to be a 3-0. He might win the coin toss. This nigga won the coin toss. You feel me? So, you know, he got the coin toss.
I see the nigga in the group now. He back in the group. I don't know if he was missing. A bitch kidnapped him. I don't know. In the R-Wing or something.
Ace, baby. I was looking for some too, though.
So listen, I know you seen the poll, because he asked me who should he battle next.
Right.
You seen what the fuck I put? The front door, motherfucker.
Nah,
fuck out of here.
That part. Go that way, my nigga. That makes me what I'm saying.
miss me with that bullshit.
We in that bar still. I was fucking with him. I was like, you gonna get in the ring with me?
Nah.
He like, Ted, I get in the ring with you. I was like, you lost already. You ain't got no shoestrings, my man.
He killed me with the head.
He wasn't wearing Skechers.
Who's a battle rapper wearing Skechers? I heard.
Was there a battle rapper out here wearing Skechers?
I'm gonna Google that.
You know who I blame for that shit?
Oh. Y'all niggas roasting my man. I fuck with Ace, man. Ace,
I fuck
actually
with Ace
got
too.
Bars though. Feel me?
Yeah.
He's different.
You gotta listen. Right.
He's just different.
Listen,
man.
Hey, yo, man. I know who I blame for that shit.
That abstract shit.
Them Syracuse niggas,
my nigga.
I blame y'all niggas for that shit, man.
Oh, man.
Don't do y'all man like that, B.
Oh, man.
Dress him up. Put him up, man.
So I'm getting him. Say, my next question would be, is there any call-outs? Anybody that you want to, you know?
Man,
invite
to
the next film.
I don't even be calling niggas out. I said this is the last time.
Because rumor has it, Keem, salute Keem for being on the show last week, you know what I mean? That he did call you out. And all call outs are made.
Look at my face when you say Keem. Like, what's some real shit? Like, Keem is a fan. Like, honestly, I swear to God, like, before he started battle rapping, that nigga was like, yo, bro, you dope, all this. Nigga, now all of a sudden you want to battle.
Talk to him! I'm sure all these little street hoopers
want to see Jordan and shit, feel me? Like, yo, Jordan. I think I get you on one.
So you said nigga had a LeVar Ball moment?
Yeah.
No, you say that he killed Jordan and shit?
It's basically for me, like, bro.
Man,
like,
he's
like,
reaching, dog.
Exactly, like, come on, bro.
Reaching.
Yo, they say I'm the LeVar Ball.
And honestly, you know what I'm saying?
Word.
Big homie, we gonna explain why you here today.
Man, I'm here just repping for the love of this hip hop thing, man. No,
first
I mean,
and foremost, always.
I ain't gonna be on no biased shit, but I feel like Swift J that shit right now.
As Big Swift, you should.
Indeed.
No, I'm Mr. I'm your baby daddy.
Oh, no!
Ask me.
Whoa!
I'm Mr. AKA your bitch new nigga. You know what I'm
saying? Oh, my God.
You know what I'm saying? So that's how that goes. You got the baby dad right there. Greatness moves together. You know,
well,
right?
No, it's
but, you know what I'm saying? So you're here on behalf of Swift.
Yeah, man. Yeah, man.
So as a parent, how does that feel? You know what I'm saying? You sit up there watching your son get up there on the ring and on the main stage and he's doing what he's doing. He's five battles in. He's going at top tier. You know what I'm saying? People that's known internationally, not just in the state, but you know what I'm saying, throughout the nation and on the globe, man. How does that make you feel? Most people see their son and daughter, you know what I'm saying, or what have you, go play lacrosse or kick balls and, you know what I'm saying, soccer, you know what I'm saying, and shit, virus in college or play football, and you watching your son murder something on stage. How do you feel?
I mean, it feel good, man. Shit, it's a good feeling, man. Knowing my little nigga out the way, you know what I mean? And the love he got for this shit, because, you know, we real hip-hop heads.
Right.
You know what I mean? You already know. We love that shit, man.
Right.
And for me to see that shit in him, and I know what he capable of, you know what I mean? It's like, man, it's like, that's my little pit bull, man. That bloodline crazy.
Ready to get on.
That bloodline crazy.
Right.
So you basically saying that you gave him a solid, sturdy foundation for all that.
And
real
I tried my best.
I know him personally. That's what for years. We damn near.
If for all you battle rappers, Tam been doing this shit. She been doing it.
Shout out H. Moe Murray's Lobby. You know what I mean? The whole thing.
You know, money, my Holly Boy treat me well.
You know what I mean? The whole thing.
Yeah.
But right now, go ahead, Mom.
But what I was going to say was, since he was little, Tam, he going to be, he the next best thing. That's all he kept saying. Tam. Get with him. Tam, watch. And I'm like, all right. And I'm listening and sharing his stuff. Before anybody even knew who Swift was, I was listening to Swift.
He was Lil Draws.
He was Lil Draws. Before he hit the battle scene, any of that. I mean, straight SoundCloud, playing with it until now. And
same,
it's like,
same.
I just watched him elevate. And it's
same
dead eye
and everything. That's why I love him. Same dead eye. You know what I call him, man? I call him a breath of fresh air, man.
Right.
Honestly, man, you ain't gonna hear too many niggas his age I ain't gonna say that shit wisdom. They doing is mumble. Yeah, that's this shit is mumble.
That's that lad baby.
Yeah, fuck that yeah. shit. We don't salute that
yeah,
shit.
We,
that's
yeah.
lad baby music.
Yeah, we ain't getting that lad check.
Nah, that shit is boy.
So I call him a breath of fresh air,
nigga,
man.
Not even rapping.
He really an element of this hip hop shit, man. And I'm gonna let it be known now. You ain't even gotta ask me, King. Where he gonna smoke boots? He gonna smoke Burns boots, man.
Burns, they calling him Burns right now.
Like OJ said, man, look at my face, man. Not for real, man. Look at my face, man. You fucking with a monster, man. Let's see a monster.
Bloodshot eyes and everything.
That's all I gotta say.
This shit
is different when it's in front of you, man. Word. And if you can recall, I asked you on the stage, is you ready for that shit to be in front of you?
What you gonna do, Burns?
Burns hit me with that. Oh, nah, he doing all right. Nah, nigga, he cooking. He doing all right, nigga. You Burns. You say you Burns. Talk to me, man.
Word.
And with that bet, I'm gonna get with you on the bet, nigga.
So I guess some spread out here. You see, you know what I mean? Hitman for hire.
I hear it.
Yes, sir.
Word. So is anything you say? Is anybody that you heard that Swift wants to battle? Any call outs? Any?
Nah, we want grievances? Stretch. Who? Nah, we want Stretch.
Oh, Stretch?
No.
Stretch Mills?
At the bird?
No, homo. I like Stretch, man. Stretch got. I wouldn't mind seeing him. OJ get Stretch.
Yeah, that would be a good one, too.
That could be a good time. You're hearing some possible cards right
that'd
now.
That would be crazy.
But that's what I'm saying, though. I don't call niggas out. Like, feel me? Like, if the people want to see that, that's what I'm like. All right, then put that together, then.
Yeah.
I just know
it makes you write harder. You know what I'm saying? When you really go in with the pen, no hose bars, you ain't holding back, you ain't taking this shit light, no light bars. It's straight killing. Like, you know you can't play. You know what I'm saying? When you step in the ring, if you ever step in the ring with this person.
Shit, honestly, you've been like, my first battle just was like, all right, I just gotta put on. And I felt like I did put on, feel me? Or I was against High Earl, or E, whatever, feel me?
Mm-hmm.
But that shit was crazy. Like, that shit has showed me, though, because, like, he won that battle. But, like, at the end of the day, it was like, I still put on. So that shit has showed me, like, all right, I gotta always just put on. Because even if a nigga come out there and do his thing, I gotta do my thing. So.
Okay.
End of the day, it's like, I'm always going to put on, I'm always going to have bars. I'm never going to come out here and not have no bars. But it's certain people that's just like even like ain't even no distance for the, feel me? Like, but I ain't even, like, I went out there and battled her and then, like, Lord, I wrote that shit in like a week. Feel me? Like,
oh,
I didn't.
Oh, you talking about a homie from
yeah.
The one they sent me after she thought she blazed every nigga in the town. They call Big Sus.
I was there for that body bag. Yeah, I was clear.
They call Big Sus.
Yo, maybe her, what's called a Savannah?
Her who?
Ace Vegas.
Ace Vegas.
I told niggas that
I'm
from level one.
Shout out to Ace Vegas.
Yo,
that ain't even.
Nah, fuck. Shout out to them
headphones.
Honestly, though.
The gold spiky
shit. Yo, them is legend.
Some niggas got their own different shit, man.
I seen a nigga
battle in like Syracuse. Well, I ain't seen a battle in Syracuse. I seen the shit on the tube. I'm watching the shit, and the nigga was saying some shit. And I'm like, yo, it's just like niggas not catching the shit.
Yeah.
Right? So he's too smart for niggas. He rhyming over niggas.
He too smart for a lot of niggas.
Overhead shit for niggas. Like, honestly, man, the nigga was like, even when we was battling, it was certain shit he was saying. I'm like, yo, son actually got some shit.
Yeah.
I'm not saying that to make, like, because at the end of the day, like, even when if you go back and look at our battle, like, if you actually listen to what he's saying and shit, the crowd's giving him reaction because the nigga actually saying some shit.
Yeah.
But it's just like, at certain times and shit, it's just like, feel me?
Over the head.
The nigga just either over the head.
Yeah, he's not grabbing the crowd as a whole. He's not grabbing the
exactly.
And that happens a lot.
He's like a daylighter.
And that's the type of thing.
That's like a good and bad thing, bro.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Nah, I done heard him spit some bars. I ain't gonna take all the goddamn credit from the nigga.
Yeah.
I done heard him say some shit. But right now, motherfuckers don't wanna hear that shit.
Yeah.
Niggas don't, man.
It's mad shit that, like, honestly, I learned that shit myself. Like, my first battle and shit, I said mad shit that I was like, yo, they ain't even react to that.
Yeah.
I'm like, man, they not gonna react to mad shit. I swear to God, then I battled Ace, and I said shit that was mad fire to me. didn't get no reaction. Then all of a sudden, I said some low, simple shit. Niggas like,
Yeah. But that's because niggas ain't thinking.
On some Lucy shit, niggas went crazy.
Went crazy. Because it was simple and they could understand.
Like, that was just like, all right, word. So, I was trying to get the fade. I'm boxing.
I've got some Lucy shit. Like,
I've
got a question for you if you're OJ. Listen, right?
Yeah.
How about you versus, damn, I just had a kid named.
That's what we for do.
That's
Did you battle Millie yet?
I would love to see that. Melly. I would love to see Melly.
Nah,
he
yo, I'm calling him and Grizz, him and T Grizz. I'm calling Battle of the Night with them two. I don't know why.
Yes.
I feel that's just gonna be Battle of the Night.
That's gonna be
you
a
know
good
what I'm
one.
Red
yes.
October.
T Grizz,
you know what I mean?
T Grizz, definitely.
So that's definitely gonna be a good one. You know what I mean?
To me, T Grizz tougher than Burns.
Oh shit! Damn.
Yeah, and on that level up we got coming up, that St. Patrick's and Bobby battle.
Word.
That shit gonna be stupid.
Yeah. You said St. Patrick?
Yeah. The niggas from Level Up.
Okay. Oh, St. James.
Whatever.
Hold on.
St. Patrick's.
Hold on.
St. James, St. Patrick's.
A holiday and shit. That's crazy. So, hold on. I heard.
That's
now,
my boy, because he put me in his bar. So, that's my boy.
Yeah, okay. What the hell was going on,
G,
at the Level Up? I heard you was out there on your...
Get him rich, yeah!
Type shit. Talk to me.
Out.
What was
yeah.
up, G?
Listen, what happened, right?
Yeah, that's
I
how
I Nah. I told niggas, like, yo, the battle about to pop off, right? That's why you don't need friends that got money, too, for me sometimes. You need some broke friends that's gonna drink some of your liquor up and shit.
Right.
I don't know if... Man, listen, shout out to Brad Piff. That nigga smoked mad weed. My nigga drink mad liquor, feel me? And came over to my house 18. With a fucking half a gallon of Henny. Nigga rolling up like 1.5 for me and fucking top papers and shit. We just getting zooted. I'm already gone. Then we like, all right, we going to the battle. Some reason we went to the liquor store. I grabbed two pints of Remy. So I be at the battle. They like, oh, they gonna let us get in with the Remy. I'm like, word. We got in with the Remy. So I'm like, all right. Battles ain't even start yet, feel me? I got one pint left, and I'm just, like, sitting there. Then, feel me, the nigga Clem, when I said, feel me, buy me them drinks and shit, the nigga ain't buy the drinks that night, so I'm like, yeah, feel me? Nigga went and bought the drinks that night, drank that shit, feel me? I still had a whole pint, then all of a sudden, nigga started battling. Honestly, man, I remember, like, three bars. And it just was crazy.
They say you ain't allowed no more.
Bro, they made an OJ rule, like what M-Way rule. I don't feel me. They saying, like, ain't no touching the battlers' balls and all that. Bro.
Right.
They all I know is that, right. Like, feel me, like, I remember just grabbing a couple of niggas. Niggas the same shit. I hear the crowd like, oh, my, like, oh. Niggas, they like, yeah. I'm like, my bad, bro. They like, bro, you tripping, man. Yo, honestly, though, I do apologize for that, man, because...
Yo, man, he was just there trying to make the
bro,
show live, man.
That's what I was. On my mama I was.
But Brad Piff, it seemed like
it was
your
Brad
fault,
Piff
man.
Fault. I swear to
God. Your fault, bro.
That nigga smokes too much weed.
Everybody can't come to the 18 meetings, man. That shit is only for a select few, man. You already know.
And
Brad
smoked
heavy.
Yo, that nigga smoked heavy.
Stone of life, indeed. You know, so, also
smoke with that nigga, though.
I do all the time, whatever we see.
Yo, job if you got shit to do, don't smoke with that nigga. Word. She like, nigga, I gotta pick my kids up.
Take this shit back, nigga. Like,
can't hold out. That shit with this nigga.
Hype. Well, let me get to the queen one time. Miss Tan, like, what you got going on? Talk to me, man. What you been doing?
Going
I heard
on.
You doing videos and shit. You
like,
out here.
For the last 2 weekends, I've been shooting videos.
Yeah. For like one song? Or
for one song.
Oh, really?
Like, yeah, because my team said Tan gotta have the best last video or the summer video out. So what I did was, last weekend, 300 college kids in a mansion. Project X.
Then in real fucking life.
Real fucking life. I mean, these kids got the tubes from the hospital, you know, they put the IVs. They drinking liquor out the IVs in my video. I got bitches on top of brown on wood pianos twerking.
Yeah.
I got
shit.
White kids, black kids, Chinese bitches twerking. Like, yeah.
And this is what you spend your college tuition money on.
Listen, big shout out to my kids.
But
then you got to understand.
Chinese bitch twerking on the video. That sounds rare. I need to see that.
Everybody go to F Unit Films.
I'm not getting no invite.
Go to YouTube. Go to F Unit Films.
You ain't getting no invite? Ain't nobody on the panel got
to call. I got an invite all over my Facebook.
Nah, I ain't hear that.
Boom. But
you're inviting me to Toy Blast, dog.
Everybody go to F Unit Films. And look up Ted, where my glass at? And you'll see a preview of it.
So that's the name of the song, Where My Glass
Where
At?
Where My Glass At. It's a club banger. It's a party banger. Okay. And then what I did last night, it was the 90s bar crawl.
Okay, well, hold on. We're going to get more
but
back to
we'll talk about it when we come back.
When we come back. Right. Back this shit, ain't you? Her. You know what I mean? She's getting back. You know what I mean? Write harder. When you, you know what I'm saying? When you really go in with the pen, no hose bars, you ain't holding back, you ain't taking this shit light, no light bars. It's straight killing, like you know you can't play. You know what I'm saying? When you step in the ring, if you ever step in the ring with this person.
Shit, honestly, it's been like, my first battle just was like, all right, I just gotta put on. And I felt like I did put on, feel me? Or I was against High Earl, or E, whatever, feel me? Mm-hmm. But that shit was crazy, like, that shit has showed me, though, because, like, he won that battle, but, like, at the end of the day, it was like, I still put on, so that shit has showed me, like, I gotta always just put on, because even if a nigga come out there and do his thing, I gotta do my thing, so.
Okay.
End of the day, it's like, I'm always gonna put on, I'm always gonna have bars, I'm never gonna come out here and not have no bars, but it's certain people that's just, like, even, like, ain't even no distance for it, feel me, like. But I ain't even, like, I went out there and battled her, and then, like, Lord, I wrote that shit in, like, a week. You feel me? Like,
oh,
I didn't.
Oh, you talking about a homie from
the one they sent me after she thought she blazed every nigga in the town. They called Big Sus.
You feel me? Like,
yeah, I was there for that body bag. Yeah, I was clear.
They called Big Sus.
Yo, maybe her, and what's called it, some battle?
Who? Her who?
Ace Vegas.
Oh,
I
told
niggas that
I
fucking
level was.
Shout out to
Ace
Vegas.
Yo, that ain't even
a
nah, fuck. Shout out to them headphones.
Honestly though.
It's
those
spiky shit, man.
Yo, them is legend. Some niggas got their own different shit, man.
Like, I heard that shit honestly, like the highest level.
For the honestly, he definitely got it.
Honestly though, I seen a nigga battle in like Syracuse. Well, I ain't seen a battle in Syracuse, but I seen the shit on the tube. I'm watching this shit, and the nigga was saying some shit, and I'm like, yo, it's just like niggas not catching this shit.
Yeah.
So you say he's too smart for niggas, he rhyming over niggas.
He's too smart for a lot of niggas.
He got overhead shit for niggas. Like, honestly, man, the nigga was like, even when we was battling, there was certain shit he was saying, I'm like, yo, son actually got some shit.
Yeah.
I'm not saying that the nigga, like, because at the end of the day, like, even when, if you go back and look at our battle, like, if you actually listen to what he's saying and shit, the crowd's giving him reaction because the nigga actually saying some shit.
Yeah.
But it's just like, at certain times and shit, it's just like, feel me?
Over the head.
The nigga just either over the
head. He's not grabbing the crowd as a whole. He's not grabbing the head. And that happens.
He's like a daylighter. He's like a daylighter.
Basically, and that's the type of thing.
That's like a good and bad thing, bro.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Now, I done heard him spit some bars. I ain't gonna take all the goddamn credit from the nigga. I done heard him say some shit, but right now, motherfuckers don't want to hear that shit.
Yeah.
Niggas don't, man.
It's mad shit that, like, honestly, I learned that shit myself. Like, my first battle and shit, I said mad shit that I was like, yo, they ain't even react to that.
Yeah.
And I'm like, man, they not gonna react to mad shit. I swear to God, damn, I battled Ace, and I said shit that was mad fire to me. Didn't get no reaction. Then all of a sudden, I said some low, simple shit. Niggas like,
yeah.
But like, that's because niggas ain't thinking.
On some Lucy shit, niggas went crazy.
It went crazy. Because it was simple and they could understand. Filler.
Like, that was just like, all right, word. So, I was trying to get the fade. I'm boxing tops on some Lucy shit. Like,
I got a question for you. If you're OJ, listen, right?
Yeah.
How about you versus, I just had a kid named.
See, that's what we for do.
That's that.
Did you battle Millie yet?
I would love to see that. Melly? I would love to see Melly.
Nah, he battled
him. That's
yo, I'm calling him and T Grizz. I'm calling Battle of the Night with them two. I don't know why, but I feel that's just going to be Battle of the Night.
That's going to be a good one.
You know what I'm saying? Red October.
T Grizz,
you know what I mean?
T Grizz, definitely.
So that's definitely going to be a good one. You know what I mean?
To me, T Grizz tougher than Burns.
Oh, shit. Damn.
Yeah. And on that Level Up we got coming up, that St. Patrick's and Bobby battle.
Word.
That shit gonna be stupid.
Yeah. You said St. Patrick?
Yeah. The lyrics from Level Up.
Okay. Oh, St. James.
Hold on.
St. James, St. Patrick.
That's crazy. So, hold on. I heard.
That's
now,
my boy, because he put me in his bar. So, that's my boy.
What the hell was going on, G,
out
at the Level Up? I heard you was out there on your...
Get him rich!
Yeah! Talk to him. What was up, G's?
Listen, what happened, right?
Yeah, that's how it is.
Nah. I told niggas, like, yo, the battle about to pop off, right? That's why you don't need friends that got money, too, for me sometimes. You need some broke friends that's going to drink some of your liquor up and shit.
Right.
Man, listen, shout out to Brad Piff. That nigga smoked mad weed. My nigga drink mad liquor, feel me? And came over to my house 18. With a fucking half a gallon of Henny. Nigga rolling up like 1.5 for me and fucking top papers and shit. We just getting zooted. I'm already gone. Then we like, all right, we going to the battle. Some reason we went to the liquor store. I grabbed two pints of Remy. So I be at the battle. They like, oh, they gonna let us get in with the Remy. I'm like, word. We got in with the Remy. So I'm like, battles ain't even start yet, feel me? I got one pint left, and I'm just, like, sitting there. Then, feel me, the nigga Clem, when I said, feel me, buy me them drinks and shit, the nigga ain't buy the drinks that night, so I'm like, yeah, feel me? Nigga went and bought the drinks that night, drank that shit, feel me? I still had a whole pint, then all of a sudden, nigga started battling. Honestly, man, I remember, like, three bars. And it just was crazy.
They say you ain't allowed no more.
Bro, they made an OJ rule, like what MMA rule, feel me? They saying like, ain't no touching the battlers' balls and all that, feel me? And then they all I know is that, like, feel me? Like, I remember just grabbing a couple of niggas. Niggas the same shit. I hear the crowd like, oh, my, like, oh! And they like, yeah. I'm like, my bad, bro. They like, bro, you tripping, man. Yo, honestly, though, I do apologize for that, man, because...
Yo, man, he was just there trying to make the show live.
I swear to God, that's what I was. Like, on my mind, I was.
But Brad Piff, it seemed like it was your fault, man.
Brad Piff, I swear to God.
It was your fault, bro.
That nigga smokes too much weed.
Everybody can't come to the 18 meetings, man. That shit is only for a select few, man. You already know.
And Brad smoked him.
Yo, that nigga smoked him.
Stone of life, indeed. You know, so,
also, don't smoke with that nigga, though.
I do all the time, whatever we see.
If you got shit to do, don't smoke with that nigga.
Word.
She like, nigga, I gotta pick my kids up. Take this shit back, man. Like,
can't hold that shit with this nigga.
Let me get to the queen one time. Miss Tan, like, what you got going on? Talk to me, man. What you been doing? I heard you doing videos and shit. You
like,
out here?
For the last 2 weekends, I've been shooting videos.
Yeah. For one song? Oh, really?
Like, because my team said Tan gotta have the best last video or the summer video out. So what I did was, last weekend, 300 college kids in a mansion. Project X.
Real fucking life.
I mean, these kids got the tubes from the hospital. You know, they put the IVs. Yeah. They drinking liquor out the IVs in my video. I got bitches on top of brown on wood pianos twerking. I got white kids, black kids, Chinese bitches twerking. Like, yeah.
And this is what you spend your college tuition money on.
Listen, big shout out to my kids. They gotta have fun. But then you gotta understand, my college kids, some of my
Chinese bitches twerking on the piano. That sounds rare. I need to see that.
Everybody go to F Unit Films.
I don't get no invite.
Go to YouTube. Go to F Unit Films.
You ain't get no invite? Ain't nobody on the panel got
to call. Get an invite all over my Facebook.
Nah, I ain't hear that.
Of it.
So that's the name of the song,
Where My Glass At. It's a club banger. It's a party banger. And then what I did last night, it was the 90s bar crawl.
Okay, well, hold on. We're going to get more
back
into that.
We're going to talk about it when we come back.
When we come back. All right, we back. Now, what you was talking about?
So last night, everybody in the town know it was the 90s bar crawl. So if you was out on East Ave, you seen me and my camera crew. And I just had the camera, and anybody who wanted to be in the video got to be in the video. I got people on East Ave doing backflips. I got the white girls twerking. I got people on a skateboard. And my video, I'm walking up.
I noticed there's a twerking theme throughout the song, which
it's
I like.
It's
I,
a,
I,
yes, I yes, of so all cultures.
So it's a twerk
I'm showing
song?
That every girl can twerk. It's not even. The song called, All I Want to Know Is Where My Glass At.
Where
the cheese and liquor past that.
So
ain't
no niggas twerking and all that shit.
No, we don't got none of that. Now, we got, well, we do got some male dancers, but ain't nobody new to nothing, but they was doing their thing.
Male dancers?
You know men that dance, they be doing that. All that stuff, that leather dance.
Yeah, they don't be jerking and shit.
Yeah, jerking and all that. So we got them doing that, skateboarding. I had so much fun. I'm walking up to people in my video. I never met a day in my life biting they slices of pizza, slapping them up. Like, it's real life. Turn up, like I showed a difference in Rochester. I walked up to him, was like, yo, that look good. Give me a bite. He held it up. I sliced it, gave him five, and we danced off. Yeah. Like, and I showed a difference in the video. Like, you know how on East Ave we had a group of whites and a group of blacks. So I come through the camera.
The pizza was a straight random moment.
I'd be like, don't nobody want to play with me. I want to play. Like, I've been trying to get a nigga to get in the ring with me forever, but it's like, they scared of what I'm going to say.
I say, yo. I'll battle you.
We're saying,
yo.
Something else we got to speak on, though. Feel me? Niggas and all these, like, honestly, like, I ain't going front. It's a couple of niggas. It's like, all right. I don't really want to battle this nigga, feel me, like that.
Because he's trash.
Because he's whack. But then certain niggas, it's like family and shit.
Yeah.
And niggas talking about they really want to see the shit. You know what I mean? And it's
end of the day, you got to, bro.
End of the day, I will battle any, I'll battle my mom if you put up a bag that's going to be like, okay.
Right. That's a fact.
I said, yo, it'd be real for mom. You know what I mean? End of the day, though, it's like, all right, we all... Well, some real shit though. End of the day, it's like, all right, we all from Rochester and shit like that. Man, I'm not trying to feel me like
y'all probably want me
to battle Swift, and nigga, I'll probably be like, oh, I could talk about this and this and that. I don't want to do that shit. Feel me? For then y'all niggas to do what? You feel me?
Yeah.
Like that shit is not getting me nowhere. Feel me? Like I go OT with Swift, and we can go kill some niggas OT, and feel me, we can get some money off of that shit. Instead of just us,
they should be like,
all right, that shit gonna be cool because it's like some shit around here, but let us go OT and all this other shit.
Wow.
Me and they shot the clips, them niggas was like, we'll never battle each other. They had a like joking around ass freestyling and battle and shit. Yeah. The niggas got paid for that shit. You don't think me and Swift, me and Chase, me and E-Ski, me and Dev, like, these is niggas that I'm not gonna battle, you feel me?
Yeah.
It's another nigga too from the Falls, you feel me? That I fuck with, like nigga Keith Bagger, nigga Outlaw, that's his battle rap for me, but
Lil Nigga,
I fuck with that little nigga, feel me?
Okay.
He's another little nigga, I see some real shit though, like I see that little nigga driving all that shit, he remind me of me, I'm like, yo, little nigga got bars and all of that shit, feel me?
He another
nigga I'm not gonna battle, cause at the same time, I wanna see him do better and all that shit, so if he set up with the right bag, anybody out there said, I'll battle him.
Right.
So it gotta make sense.
It's top list of people, but certain niggas is like, I don't want, like,
but here, I can't
battle niggas because niggas ain't even on my caliber.
We do say no to fluff. We ain't down with the fluffing. You know what I mean? How niggas get in the ring, and oh, that's my man, so I'm not gonna go too hard.
This is why I don't do it like that, homie. It's like, y'all, like, I
I respect that. I respect the fact that you would rather not do it than to get in there and bullshit. You know what I mean?
Because if I do
the fans
want to
see
like,
some real shit. Exactly. They don't want to see things in there.
Once I sign up, it's Operation Kill.
Exactly.
I don't care who you is. And one thing about me, I don't have no remorse. I am the pettiest when it comes to that pen and paper. Like, I might talk about your grandmama in ICU. I have no bars hold. That's why when I battled and they went to talking about my baby, I'm like, yo, y'all, my squad, like, yo, we about to beat this bitch. I'm like, no. Because if they would have let me go
she
past.
She would have got run red. You know what I mean?
If I wouldn't have stopped them, it would have been tragic for them. But shout out to my sugar cane gang.
Honestly, that whole little package. I'm just not. Salute to King Fing. Salute to King Fing, though. He shows promise.
Everything.
You know what I mean? God bless the dead. You know what I mean?
God bless
the dead. He shows promise. Yeah. He just got to, you know what I'm saying, get his performance size up. Right.
He just got to get away from
him. Oh, yeah, I forgot all about him. Victories don't count. He did 3-0.
Bro, some real shit, though. Like, even if, okay, SDK is upstate heavyweight from me, Niagara Falls. He's upstate heavyweight shit.
Hey, yo,
let's talk about on-site for real, feel me? Who on-site, that's on-site battle
hold up, OJ.
Is the worst.
Hold up, OJ.
Let's be real about this.
Who the worst? And I don't even know my nigga. Shout out to Buddha. Nigga, I know you get money.
Right.
Joking you to feel me? Like,
yeah, you gotta be prepared.
I'm not even gonna hold you.
Like somebody that really do this shit. It ain't just a hobby. So you niggas gotta decide, is it a hobby or is this what your livelihood is? Is this what you're trying to make money off? Are you trying to take care of your family off this? And if so, get serious.
Okay,
yeah, we be for real with just this. Doing it so, for a sport.
So we all agree, Buddha, the wagon snake, or.
No.
No, we,
no, we don't.
She
no,
she begs the difference.
No, we don't.
Me.
No,
so, right now, Leeway.
Until my brother Leeway remember his bars all three rounds, okay. He is considered.
So you're saying Leeway, Ace Vegas, and Booter are at the bottom?
Yes. Yes.
You know what I'm saying? So we hold on. We gonna get back into this list.
We can finish it when we come back.
Who's the wackest in about 2 seconds? You dig me right back.
Rochester, get ready as the on-site battle league presents. Fall's first big event. Get ready for Red October. Sunday, October 22nd. It's for the money. It's for the coach. It's for battle rap bragging rights. It's Red October. At California Brew House, 402 West Ridge Road. Get ready for bars. Get ready for punchlines. It's the on-site battle league. Get ready for Burns the Fireman versus Swift Jet. Jess Mills versus Stupid Bar. Esky versus Ivan the Great. Young Melly versus T. Griff. Fenway OJ versus B. Goon. Rochester, get ready as the on-site battle league presents. Fall's first big event. Get ready for Red October. With your host, on-site Tom and CEO Daniel. Doors open at 8 p.m. and general admission tickets are only $20. Sunday, October 22nd. It's for the money. It's for the culture. It's for battle rap bragging rights. It's Red October. At California Brew House, 402 West Ridge Road. Sunday, October 22nd, it's the on-site battle league with the big boys battle.
All right, we back. Talking that shit as usual. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So what were we talking about last week? Oh, we still on that who's wacky.
Yeah. Well,
who's wacky? So,
we all
so
agree.
Far, the panel has come up with, you know what I mean? And not we already don't see who the fuck said what. It's in no particular order. Vegas, Ace Vegas, if you didn't catch it, Booter, and Leeway. Is there anybody else we want to add? Oh, and we said Niagara Falls is a collective.
As a collective.
You know what I mean? As a collective, as a unit. Unit. Minus King Fan, because he does show, you know what I'm saying, promise, but right now he's dead. So, you know what
they booked him right.
You know what I mean? They booked him right that time.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Zeus need to work on his craft too.
Zeus?
Yes.
Yeah.
Zeus Jumadi.
You know, that's what I'm thinking about. He did the level up and he never caught, like, he maybe one or two little oohs or ahs or something from him, but it wasn't really punchy.
So he's
at the end of the day,
it wasn't punchy.
No fluff, is he tree?
No fluff, he tree.
Okay. So we ain't gonna give him on the backwards here. Never mind.
Punch and punch and never stop punching, and they disappointed me a little.
Ooh.
My boy
Cut it up.
I was at level
but the nigga right now with that level up is the nigga
St. James.
Same story.
I gotta say, King is definitely doing it.
Keem and
running that level up right now.
Oh, between Keem and
they say Keem that nigga too now.
Yeah, Keem.
Keem dope. Keem dope too.
Like Keem on some shit. Word, but fam talking about some all call outs mandatory, bro. Down
Keem,
here,
my boy.
Word.
It be times like
I said all call
as a big sister.
Bro, that's in jail. Okay, you want to fight? That's
as a big sister.
Don't call outs mandatory, nigga.
A lot of my brothers. They come to me and be like, they pull me to the side, what you think about this? What I should do about it? Because they know I'm not going to hold no punches with them.
Right.
So a lot of times, I be hearing bars before a show even comes.
Yeah.
You feel me?
That's what I'll
so when it come down to it, I be like, okay, now it's on. I'm not even watching what you're saying because I already heard what you're saying. Now how you going to deliver it? Is you going to deliver it like you're supposed to? Because you can have the illest bars. But if you ain't delivering that shit,
that's why talking. That's why old buddy dead. The nigga from Niagara Falls.
Oh, SDK?
Nah, not him.
Full fame. Moment of silence.
And look, right? Who the other nigga from the Niagara Falls?
Really?
He looked like an
SDK.
An R&B nigga.
Oh!
chiming in.
Let's talk about that, bro.
In.
You got a bang in your picture, bro. I don't understand what's going on now. You got the edge control going crazy right now.
That nigga said.
You know what I mean?
That nigga said.
What's up with it? What's up with it? Like, come talk to me, man. We in the barbershop. I can get you together, man.
Get niggas the curly shit.
He right along behind somebody, pause, you know what I'm saying?
Girl. Hey yo, shout out to Michelle and what's the other girl? Shout out to Michelle and Chastity.
Y'all niggas
crazy.
Y'all both
side
fuckers.
Word.
Shout out to
Yo, Chastity, yo, your bum with them bars though. I be seeing her. She stay battling you.
She
be like, yo, anyway, I was like, hey, yo.
She funny though. She like, yo, I just got done writing in rounds for you. I'm like, girl.
Yo, anyway, I got a question for you, baby.
I'm listening.
Who won between Swift and Death?
Swift and Death. Honestly, I think Swift didn't win. Feel me? But he taught Dev a big fact, you feel me? Like, I feel like Dev...
So you say Dev won?
I feel like Dev won. That's how I feel.
What makes you feel Dev won?
Because on some real shit, though, I feel like, even like how niggas say, though, with the crowd and all that shit, I respect all that. But, like, I'm a nigga that just listen to certain shit. Like, 40 and Dev, I swear to God, like, if you listen to that shit... Like, the nigga 40 was actually saying some shit.
Yeah. I was there when they was like,
Can I say what I want on that
like
battle?
A rapper. Feel me? Like some old.
I felt like 40 killed that. And I like that. Shout out to that.
A lot of people would think that. And so I wouldn't think that. And
I listened to the bars.
But as a battle rapper wise, it's like, all right, I already told niggas why. Like, even in the same, like, when I did an interview beforehand, I think 40's gonna lose. I'm 40 before I knew that.
See, where 40 fucked up.
40 came to with the Midtown Plaza swag.
Yeah, but he fucked up because he was, you know, he was going too fast. His delivery.
He getting too complex. Listen, as soon as you get too complex, they don't understand it.
Yeah.
He's gonna got calculated.
I think it was just, the way he delivered it. That's
the way he delivered it.
He just delivered it so rapid fire.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? That's what it's called, the rapid fire flow.
Niggas is drunk as a bitch in the crowd.
Shout out to my real hood niggas. Quarter
Water.
Quarter water.
Shout out Black from Three Kings, because I'm only talking shit to him. Yeah.
Nah,
I'm having Quarter Water and shit.
But nah, end of the day though.
So you say Dev won?
I feel like my niggas come with a whole, basically like, all right, we battle rapping. It's like we battle rapping, feel me? But honestly, I feel like Swift first battles was like track battles. Feel me? He's starting to get the format now.
Yeah,
and I feel like 40 is basically seeing that now that he battled Dev, you feel me?
Yeah.
And that's why I feel like 40 lost that battle. If it was like, okay, you was trying to spit that shit on the beat, okay, y'all.
You just Tupac that nigga.
All that entertainment shit, like, feel me? All the joking and shit, all the this shit and that shit, like, bro, it's mad more shit to battle rap than I thought it was.
Yeah.
I went to my first battle and just had straight bars, I ain't had no jokes.
That's how you say Swift was.
You know what I love? I've been working on.
I'm not saying that he lost.
Look, Dev killed 40 on swag.
Yeah.
He killed him on swag. He killed him.
And that's it.
You know what I mean? 40 got up on there with that little ass wife beater. Like he was cooking up and shit. Come on, man. He threw 40. Shout out to 40.
Shout out to those.
Dev on the little wife beater. He was in there. He had on the cook-up outfit. He ain't come to battle.
That's my son too. Like I fuck
40 a good nigga, man.
40 been doing 40 this for a while though.
He been doing this for a while.
I fuck with the young boy.
That's how I know. Yeah. I wasn't worried about
always
him coming
have,
out
man.
With the bars.
Always
my whole thing was how he was gonna deliver because the way battling has changed
right
from Midtown Plaza to now.
He's
holding
the
way.
A rapper that is like, all right, he gotta get props from the older heads and shit
he
because he's saying shit that's like real nigga shit.
And I understood everything that nigga
like,
was saying.
That nigga had that kitchen outfit on, nigga. Cooking up. He came 40 cash straight from the kitchen. He forgot he had a battle.
I've been working on them punches where, like, when I battled Skrilla and I used the juice game.
No, that was a nigga.
When I was like,
you niggas not gonna tell me that was a bra. You niggas not gonna keep telling me that was a bra.
That is a girl.
I gotta see the bitch.
These niggas don't get schemes at all in on site. The nigga is stretch the win from Stool and Stretch, you feel me? Because honestly, the nigga Stool, he just on a high horse and shit, and honestly, you don't understand, like, you, like, for me, like, you want to, like...
Five battles in, B. It's certain,
you feel me? You get that ass open, you start learning, like, word. Yeah. Like, don't get me wrong, like, my first battle, I lost. And it's like, too. I lost it because I lost it in four rounds. Like, niggas ain't telling me we was about to battle four rounds.
See, you was there.
I was there. And my first battle was four rounds.
So I'm saying that, different for Swift.
What I'm saying is that, even so, though, it's mad different for Swift. Like, yeah. Swift's first one was a body. Yeah. And then even the second one, he felt like it was a body. So I felt like, all right, I'm not saying that, okay, you lost to death. I feel like you lost to death. Yeah. Who's running daddy? You feel like you won? Bro.
I put on. He burned them.
You feel me? That's what I'm saying. Like, if you put on, why would you feel like you lost?
If you
were stumbling and all that shit, like, okay, then that's only less than that.
Yeah.
But yeah.
So basically, you want Swift to win, but you really can't call it because, you know what I'm saying?
It's gonna be stupid to say that Burns is gonna lose because Burns comes to the show with shit.
Don't get me wrong,
it was a couple of bars in his Charlie Clips battle that had me like,
Burns got bars.
But honestly though, it was a tournament though, so I understand that too, because he had to basically work his way up to Charlie Clips. But then
it was like last minute.
But he killed all the niggas to get the Charlie Clips.
But he beat the niggas to get the Charlie Clips. Everybody signed up for that shit. Nah, the one kid was spitting. Any shout out to Jay and all of that.
Shout out
to Melody J here. Three Kings, you feel me? Salute.
Next Life to the Next Life, you feel me?
Yes.
Rattle Gang. That's our shit, you feel me? That's CJA. That's Tommy. That's Tommy. Tommy, you feel me?
I'm doing my shout out. Alright, we're going back and forth, nigga. Tom, Chase.
You feel me? Okay. Good luck, Brody, for that. Or CJ.
Shout out all my on-site battle league team. My on-site battle league fan page. For everybody who active. Because without the fans, we ain't doing shit. Shout them out, all my SKG girls, all my Tan fans, everybody who just love the culture. We love y'all too, because without y'all, we just doing this shit for smoke.
Exactly.
For smoke, big sweat. Anybody want to shout out? Yo, man, shout out the on-site. Shout out Three Kings. Mm-hmm. Talk That Shit Radio.
Yes.
Southside Up. Every side of town.
Yes.
Every part of the earth. You understand? Shout out Team Hiddle. Hit'em Squad, 50-50, Blackheart, you know what I mean? Like Ted said, it's for the culture, man.
Right,
do it for the love, man. Uh-huh. And, you know, niggas really got to bring bars, man. Leave that bullshit at home, man.
No please. Fluff.
Please, leave the bullshit. If your man whack, your man whack, man.
No
God
fluff.
Damn, man. Word, man.
Dig what I'm saying?
Word.
No fluff.
And before we go, OJ had the motherfucking bar of the year. Fuck what nigga said. When that nigga said, when I bust on her feet, huh? We thinking baby steps.
Ow!
Word. So you already bust on her feet. We taking
from
baby
me,
steps.
Your boy Destroy once again, the ghetto tour guy, you know what I mean? Salute Three Kings, whatever company, you know what I mean? Mother the Mayhem on site, you know what I mean? Southside Unk, I see you. And the next, you know what I'm saying, the next edition until we back again. Gonna talk that shit, you know. Oh yeah, fuck your feelings.
Yeah.